हेलो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ अशोक बगड़ा फ्रॉम डॉक्टर सुभाष टेक्निकल कैंपस वेलकमिंग यू इन द लेक्चर्स ऑफ डायनेमिक्स ऑफ मशीनरी। एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट बैलेंसिंग ऑफ फोर सिलेंडर इनलाइन इंजन। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल माय डियर फ्रेंड, लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट द इनलाइन इंजन। सो हियर we are going to discuss about balancing of four cylinder inline engine. So we know that if there are four cylinder, then it is known as a four cylinder engine, but here the inline engine. So my dear friends, when the axis of all cylinder, so this is the axis of cylinder, so these are the axis of cylinder, when the axis of cylinders are in the same plane, so my dear friends, you can clearly see that this is the axis of cylinder 1, this is the axis of cylinder 2, axis of cylinder 3 and axis of cylinder 4, all are in a vertical plane. So if the axis of all cylinders, if axis of all cylinders are in the same plane and on the same side of the axis of crankshaft, so my dear friends, it is clearly seen that all cylinders are on the same side of the axis of crank. So this is the axis of crank, these are the cylinders, so all cylinders are placed in the one side of crank shaft. So that's why it is known as this type of engine are known as a four cylinder inline engine. So let us consider a four cylinder inline engine having two inner cranks and two outer cranks. My dear friends, there are four cranks, there are four cylinders, so there are four cranks, crank 1, crank 2, crank 3 and crank 4. Out of this four crank, there are two, these crank 1 and crank 4 are known as outer crank, crank 2 and crank 3 are known as a inner crank. So let us consider a four cylinder engine having two inner cranks. That means this four cylinder engine having crank 1 and crank 4 are outer cranks and crank 2 and crank 3 are inner cranks. As shown in figure, in a center we have considered one reference plane, and from the reference plane we have considered the cylinder 1, the center line of cylinder 1 is placed at L1 distance, the center line of cylinder 2 is placed at L2 distance, similarly center line of cylinder 3 is placed at L3 distance and center line of cylinder 4 is placed at L4 distance. The inner cranks 2 and 3, now let us consider the inner crank 2 and 3 are 180 degree from the outer crank 1 and 4. So my dear friends, we assume the initial condition. So inner cranks makes an angle 180 degree with outer cranks. So if we assume the crank 1 which make an angle theta degree with the center line of cylinder 1, then the outer crank also makes an angle, same angle, because outer crank makes an angle theta degree. But the inner cranks makes an angle 180 degree from the outer crank. So that's why the crank 2 makes an angle 180 degree plus theta degree. So inner cranks having same angle and outer cranks having same angle. Now my dear friends, we know that the unbalanced force is due to the reciprocating mass of each cylinder. My dear friends, we have already discussed in a single cylinder engine. So in a single cylinder engine, primary force and secondary forces are acting along the line of stroke. So there are four cylinders, so the unbalanced force is due to the reciprocating mass of each cylinder. So primary force, we know that is m omega square r cos theta. Secondary force Fs is equal to m omega square r into cos 2 theta upon n. Similarly, this forces are in a different plane, are at some distances from the reference plane. So some couple may be also developing all cylinders, all engines. So unbalanced couple about the reference plane due to the reciprocating of each cylinder are primary couple is equal to Cp is equal to m omega square r into L r cos theta. Similarly, secondary couple is equal to m omega square r into L cos 2 theta upon n. My dear friends, here we all know that m is the mass of reciprocating parts per cylinder, omega is the angular speed of crank in radian per second, r is the radius of crank, theta, so theta is the angle made by the crank with the line of stroke, or we can say that central line of cylinder. And here n is the obliquity ratio, so n is equal to L by r, so here L is a length of. So my dear friends, here n is equal to L upon r, but here L is a length of connecting rod, and here L is a distance from distance of central line of cylinders from the reference plane. So my dear friends, let us calculate the data for the force and couple in the form of table. So my dear friends, as shown in figure, there are four cylinders, so we consider all cylinders are in a plane. So there are four planes, so that's why we consider in the first column planes. So there are four planes, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then masses, another column is mass. So in each cylinder there are one reciprocating mass having m, so m is the mass of reciprocating part. The radius, there are four cranks, and all cranks having same radius, so having radius is r. So, my dear friends, we know that centrifugal force, but here we consider centrifugal force without omega square, so that's why mr. So but that means we consider the centrifugal force in kg into meter, so mr is a centrifugal force for all plane. Now the distance from rp, my dear friends, as seen in figure, so this is a reference plane, so towards the left direction we consider negative distance, and towards the right direction from the reference plane positive distance. So my dear friends, the distance between reference plane and plane 1 is L1, but minus L1. Similarly, the distance between central line of cylinder 2 and reference plane is L2, but minus. So here we put the distance from RP in meter. So minus L1, minus L2, L3 and L4. My dear friends, then we can calculate couple. So we know that force into distance. So this is centrifugal force, this is distance, so we can calculate the couple. So minus mr L1, minus mr L2, mr L3, mr L4. So this is the column of couple without considering omega square. Now my dear friends, let us consider the primary crank position theta. So let us assume that the first crank, that means inner cranks, make an angle 0 degree with the line of stroke, or we can say that the first, that means outer cranks, makes an angle 0 degree with the central line of cylinders, so theta is 0. So here we can also consider theta is 0, and here 180 degree plus 0, that means it is 180 degree, and it is also 180 degree. So primary crank position theta 1 is 0, theta 2 is 180 degree, theta 3 is 180 degree, and theta 4 is also 0. Similarly, secondary crank position, so my dear friends, we know that secondary crank position is 2 theta, so the double of 0 degree is also 0 degree, here 360 degree, here also 360 degree, and here also 0 degree. Now let us draw a primary force polygon and primary couple polygon. So my dear friends, first of all, let us draw a primary crank position. So this is the reference, and this is O, is the center of rotation of crank. My dear friends, crank 1, as shown in figure, crank 1 which make an angle 0 degree, and crank 4 also makes an angle 0 degree. So here, from at 0 degree, we draw a first crank. So crank 1 is here at 0 degree. Similarly, crank 4 is having also angle 0 degree. And we place here 2 and 3. So crank 2 and 3 makes an angle 180 degree from the reference line. So here we put the crank 2 and crank 3. Now my dear friends, let us draw a force polygon, primary force polygon. So we know that there are four forces, MR, MR, MR and MR. So all the forces having same magnitude but difference in direction. So my dear friends, we start from the zero, O. So this is O. Okay, we draw FP1 having magnitude is MR and at 0 degree. So from O, we draw FP1 having magnitude is MR. So we consider, we select some scale and then we draw FP1 at 0 degree. Similarly, from A, we draw FP2 at 180 degree, my dear friends, at 180 degree. So, okay, then we draw, first of all, let us draw the FP4, my dear friends. First, we have drawn FP1, this is FP1, then we draw FP4. So, FP4, it is also at 0 degree, but having same magnitude. So, here we draw FP4, so this is B point. Then, my dear friends, FP2 is 180 degree. So, FP2 is at 180 degree. So, from B point, from this B point, we draw FP2 here. And from this C point, we draw FP3. It is also at 180 degree. So, here we draw FP3. So, my dear friends, in a force polygon, the starting point and ending point both are common. That means our polygon is closed. So, we can say that here, the primary unbalanced force is zero. Because our polygon is closed, so we can say that primary unbalanced force is zero. Now, we draw a primary force polygon. My dear friends, primary force polygon. So, we know that primary let us draw a primary couple polygon. So again, CP1, it is a primary couple due to the primary force 1. So it is minus MRL1 at 0 degree. So this is the starting point O. From the O, we draw CP1 at 0 degree. But the magnitude is in negative direction, so we consider in this direction. So this is CP1. So OAS is a CP1. Then we draw CP3, my dear friends. So CP3, we draw CP3. Okay, second one, my dear friends, we consider from the A, we draw a CP2. So CP2, it is also minus. So we 180 degree, we draw CP2 at 180 degree, but in a negative direction. So we draw CP2 at here. Similarly, at 0 degree, we draw CP4. So this is CP4. B dash, C dash is a CP4. And finally, we draw CP3 at 180 degree. So this is a CP4, C dash, D dash. So, my dear friends, in a primary couple polygon also, starting point and ending point is common. So, we can say that the primary couple polygon, it is also a closed polygon. So, we know that if polygon is closed, then there is a zero unbalanced couple. That means, so here from this polygon, we can say that this, in this case, there is a zero unbalanced couple. Now, let us draw a secondary force polygon and secondary couple polygon. So let us draw the crank position, my dear friends. So this is the center of rotation of crank, O. My dear friends, in a secondary crank angle, so we know that there are 0 degree, 360, 360 and 360. That means all positions are same. So my dear friends, here we draw at 0 degree crank 1. Similarly, crank 2, crank 3 and crank 4. And the radius of this secondary crank is r/4n and it is rotating at 2 omega speed. So let us draw a secondary force polygon, my dear friends. So we know that there are four forces, Fs1, Fs2, Fs3 and Fs4. but having same magnitude. MR is a common magnitude for all these forces. So we know that from the O, let us consider this is O, it is a starting point. From the OA at 0 degree, we draw MR, that means F has 1. Similarly, from A, we draw F has 2, it is also at 0 degree. Similarly, we draw F has 3, and similarly, we draw F has 4 at 0 degree. So, my dear friends, so OA is a F has 1, AB is F has 2, BC is F has 3, and CD is F has 4. But in this case, my dear friends, starting point is O and ending point is D. So, my dear friends, this is a unclosed polygon. So, if you measure OD, then this is a unbalanced secondary force. So, my dear friends, unbalanced secondary force, from the figure, we can clearly see that it is nothing but it is a summation of all forces. So, unbalanced secondary force is equal to, we can say that FS1 plus FS2 plus FS3 plus FS4. But this force is without omega square and n. So we multiply here omega square into n. So finally we get Fsu is equal to 4mr into omega square divided by 4. So this is our secondary unbalanced force. Now my dear friends, we are going to draw a secondary couple polygon. So again, same procedure. So this is the starting point O. From the O, we draw a couple having magnitudes minus MRL. So here, my dear friends, the magnitude is negative. So we draw at a 0 degree. So we draw in a left direction. So CS1. So O A dash is a CS1. So second one is a, my dear friends, again, minus. It is MRL4. It is also at 0 degree. So, MRL4 is also at a 0 degree. So, this is O'A' is a CS1. Then AC, it is a CS4. Then CD is a CS3. So, my dear friends, in this case also we get starting point and ending point is common. So that's why couple polygon, it is also closed polygon. So we can say that the unbalanced secondary couple is also zero. So my dear friends, in this case, primary unbalanced forces is zero, as we have derived from this polygon. Primary unbalanced couple is also zero. Secondary unbalanced couple is also zero. But we have secondary unbalanced force is equal to 4mr into omega square divided by n. So this is the secondary unbalanced couple. So my dear friends, this is the balancing of four cylinder inline engine. Thank you.